Hi, my name is Ruben Alves. I'm from Robotics Ignite Academy, and today we are going to see what is a ROS package. And for that you are going to use this platform, which is the best one if you want to learn ROS really fast. Okay, let's get started. For that, let me launch this course, ROS Basics in 5 days in C++, to see what is a ROS package and how to navigate, for example. A ROS package, according to the official ROS documentation, is like the main unit to keep ROS organized. If you want to have a code to do anything in ROS, let's say move a robot, download data from anywhere, you must have a ROS package. And how to create a ROS package is really easy. If you go here to the catkin org space, we can create here a package. For example, we can catkin create a package, let's say my package, and depends on RosPy. If you see this folder, my package, the only thing we have here is a package.xml, CMake list, and an empty src folder. But this is a ROS package already. A package is basically a folder that contains this package XML that is here. Let's open. And this file has a specific structure and with the name of the package here. For example, this is all filled by this catkin create package automatically. So if I just remove this package, if I just rename, let's say move, if I just move package to no package, let's say put anything that is not a package, ROS can't find this package anymore. If I just rcd my package, for example, okay, ROS can't find. Now if I move back there and rename no package to package XML again and run exactly the same command, now ROS will be able to find it. Yes, and yes, the structure of a package is basically we must have this package XML, we have this CMake list that is used when we want to compile our package, of course, the source folder that contains some scripts, we normally also have the scripts folder, launch folder, a folder that contains our services, messages, and include. Yes, these are like you must have also configured. These folders are empty, of course, because I've just created them. But this is like the basic structure to the most common files that you are going to see in a package. And if you want to see all the packages, you have packages for almost everything in ROS. You can see the list of all packages with just ROS pack list, for example. We have here, we can't imagine how many packages we have here, but it's a lot. If you just use this word counter, for example, to count the number of lines, we can see that we have here 780 packages. It's a lot. You can do almost everything with all these packages. And let's run, for example, we in this Unity ROS Basics of the ROS Basics in 5 days course, we have here a command to control the robot. If you check here, we have a file, so it's inside a package, in this case TurtleBot Teleop. And yeah, you must have a package for anything in ROS basically. If you just run this command, for example, we can control this robot. If you look here on the right side, by the way, let me change here to a bigger, okay, let's make the simulation bigger. So you can see, let's rotate the robot, for example. And yes, this code is basically inside of a package. And yeah, packaging in ROS is used everywhere. Okay guys, this was the video for today. It was basically to explain how the basic structure of ROS and the main files that you find, the basic structure, I mean, of a ROS package, and the main scripts, the main structure of a package, and yeah, how to use it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked the video, please give us a thumbs up. And you also can subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every single day. Thanks for watching.